There's a growing body of research on how blood pressure affects risk for cognitive decline and dementia. Two studies published in the current issue of JAMA add important pieces to that puzzle.
Blood pressure control, especially in midlife, could be a very strong way for this country and the world to consider how do we tackle dementia, which is going to be one of the major conditions that affects society.
That's Shyam Prabhakaran. He wrote an editorial about the two studies.
Because it's so simple, because it's blood pressure control, it makes it even more of a reason to begin to do that even better than we do currently.
Let's look at the SprintMind MRI study first. SprintMind is the cognition substudy of Sprint. And in January, JAMA published the first part of SprintMind, which was a randomized trial comparing intensive versus standard BP control and probable dementia. In that study, researchers reported a non-significant reduction in probable dementia, but a significant reduction in mild cognitive impairment in the intensive treatment group over a 5-year follow-up. The new MRI study was also conducted by the SprintMind research group. In the new study, the researchers report on a subset of Sprint participants. The researchers looked at structural changes in the brain.
So not only are we talking about targets, now we're saying that there may be biomarkers in the brain that are showing protective or beneficial changes of blood pressure lowering.
The primary outcome in this study was white matter hyperintensity on MRI imaging.
White matter hyperintensities are an imaging feature of small vessel ischemic disease. This is a form of vascular injury in the brain.
If you're looking at an MRI, white matter hyperintensity or white matter lesions are best seen on a sequence called flare. That's the one in the middle. White matter hyperintensity will show up as a bright spot. But what they mean clinically is a little less clear.
They are very commonly seen in small levels with aging, but they are an indication of the presence of vascular disease, and especially when the amount of white matter hypertensity increases to a high level, those are really indicative of the presence of significant vascular damage enough to cause vascular cognitive impairment or vascular dementia.
The findings of the study were twofold.
In SprintMind, intensive blood pressure lowering was able to slow down white matter hyperintensity progression, but did lead to some increase in brain shrinkage or atrophy.
The differences were small, but statistically significant.
So one has to grapple with whether, on the one hand, reducing a biomarker associated with dementia, white matter hyperintensity progression, is good, but is it okay for brain volume to be reduced? And is that shrinkage or atrophy going to counter the benefits of reducing white matter hyperintensity progression? We don't know the answer to that.
The brain volume can have multiple things going on. One thing that affects brain volume is neurodegenerative disease, for example. That tends to have a much more profound change over time than what we saw in our group. But even things like hydration status, for example, can change brain volume. So we don't actually know what that effect is due to. I think that's something that we want to try to investigate a little further.
Many other questions remain. White matter lesions are a risk factor for cognitive decline and dementia, but it's uncertain what structural or cognitive changes might be observed with a longer follow-up.
Everything about hypertension, people are hypertensive for, you know, decades, half their life even, and these are having effects on their brain constantly, continually over that time period. And we were measuring kind of a very short window in that period.
And it's this long-term effect of blood pressure on dementia that's addressed by the ARIC study, published in the same issue of JAMA.
So this is the cohort called the Atherosclerosis Risk and Communities Cohort, abbreviated as the ARIC cohort, and it was started back in 1987. So people were enrolled in this study during middle adulthood. Having this midlife data is really what makes a lot of the work we do in this cohort unique, because we can look at how midlife and late life factors interact to influence late life outcomes like dementia.
After enrollment, participants' blood pressure was measured during 5 in-person visits over 24 years. Based on these measurements, the researchers categorized the participants into 5 blood pressure patterns.
What we did was we saw how category membership, or these longitudinal blood pressure patterns, related to subsequent risk of dementia. So developing dementia in late life after blood pressure had been measured.
The findings suggest that blood pressure even as early as midlife may influence longer-term cognitive outcomes. 2 patterns were statistically significantly associated with incidence of dementia: chronic hypertension and midlife hypertension followed by late-life hypotension.
We did compare the two groups because we were really interested in this question. Like, is the midlife hypertension, late-life hypotension group actually worse than having, you know, chronic hypertension? And when we compared the two groups head-to-head, we didn't see any statistically significant differences. And that's important. But, you know, there is some separation between the groups that may or may not be, you know, just a normal variation.
It may be that this is all just exposure to a longer period of hypertension from midlife onward, but there was a signal, a potential signal of increased risk with hypotension later in life. So they could be interacting with each other in some complex way where it sets the stage where very low blood pressures is particularly harmful in late life.
I would encourage further research looking at this group as, you know, potentially being more pathogenic than the group that maintains elevated blood pressure, because I think it's important for understanding how to treat blood pressure in older adults, especially older adults who have a chronic history of hypertension in midlife.
And this is key. Together, these studies suggest that hypertension is a modifiable risk factor for dementia, and more intensive blood pressure control from midlife might reduce dementia incidence in hypertensive patients.